Make sure to like this video in 4.5 seconds or Goldberg will never lose the Universal Championship. Pop the top, it's time for another video to drop. And today we're diving into the WWE history books to take a look at five moments that Vince McMahon wants you to forget happened in the WWE. Now, can you really blame Vince McMahon though? When you have six weekly shows you're filming, which accumulates to 10 hours of weekly television, there are bound to be moments that we wish we could all forget. But I mean, hey, I wish I could forget all about Brock Lesnar jobbing out Kofi Kingston for the WWE Championship just to push an awful ex-UFC feud. But I mean, the WWE will never let me do that, let's be honest here. WrestleMania 20's fairy tale ending. WrestleMania 20, which took place on March 14th, 2004, had one of the best ending moments in WrestleMania history, but Vince McMahon wants you to completely forget all about this. Granted, I'll have to be honest, I'm not sure if you can honestly blame Vince for this one. To catch you up to speed, during the 20th anniversary of WrestleMania, we saw Eddie Guerrero retain his WWE Championship earlier in the night, defeating Kurt Angle, a victory which does often get remembered in the WWE history books. However, the main event of WrestleMania 20, on the other hand, is a completely different story. The World Heavyweight Championship was on the line as Triple H entered the event as the world champion. He was set to defend his championship in a triple threat match against the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, and the winner of the 2004 Royal Rumble, Chris Benoit. The trio would put on an absolute instant classic of a triple threat match, where at the end of the match, it'd come down to Chris Benoit winning the match via his patented finisher, the Crippler Crossface, becoming the World Heavyweight Champion. Now after the match, Chris and real-life best friend Eddie Guerrero would embrace in the middle of the ring as confetti fell atop of the two celebrating world champions. Real-life best friends were now at the top of their mountain of their respected brands in the WWE. This moment was truly a fairy tale ending for WrestleMania 20. But given the circumstances of Chris Benoit's last days on Earth, the WWE has completely wiped him from the history books and has also made it a strong point that they will never mention his name in programming again, as mentioned by Vicky Guerrero in the latest episode of the hit Vice show, Dark Side of the Ring. Although we've known for over a decade now that this was always and will always be the case going forward when it comes to the WWE and Chris Benoit. The Rise of Mustafa Ali. In late 2018, Mustafa Ali made the jump from 205 Live over onto the SmackDown Live brand. In his first night on the brand, he challenged then WWE Champion Daniel Bryan to a match and was given a non-title match, in which he did come out on a losing effort. However, by the end of the match, Ali's stock in the WWE rose higher than it ever had before. Mustafa Ali was always viewed as one of the best pure babyfaces that WWE had during his time on 205 Live, and this was nothing short of different either. Mustafa's transition to SmackDown Live was one that had fans both excited to see new talent on the brand and also happy to see someone they've supported being given the opportunity to try and make a name for themselves nearly right away. It was even slated for Mustafa Ali to possibly head into WrestleMania to face Daniel Bryan for the WWE Championship. However, Mustafa Ali's momentum would spiral down in the month of February as he landed an injury that caused him to miss out on the Elimination Chamber match, ultimately being replaced with Kofi Kingston. Now, as the story goes, Kofi Kingston's road to WrestleMania truly began due to the roadblock that Ali had to face. While Kofi Mania did indeed work out and everyone was extremely happy for Kofi Kingston becoming WWE Champion for the first time in his career, I can't help but to wonder what Mustafa Ali's career would look like right now had that injury in February never happened and it had been Mustafa who won the WWE Championship at WrestleMania. Now, since then, Vince McMahon and the WWE really have not talked about Mustafa Ali's actual beginnings on the SmackDown Live brand. I'm very interested to see if that does change in the future, but for now, Vince McMahon certainly does not want you to remember the rise of Mustafa Ali. The Army Tank with a Ferrari Engine. Do you remember when NXT was a game show instead of a developmental company? Comment down below with hashtag NXT if you remember. I know Bray Wyatt certainly remembers NXT being a game show, and after all, on the second season of NXT, there was an awfully familiar face featured as one of the contestants. Before there was a Bray Wyatt, there was Husky Harris. The former Florida Championship Wrestling Tag Team Champion was selected to take part in the second season of NXT, with his pro being Cody Rhodes. Now, I'd love to sit here and tell you all about all of the accolades that Husky Harris went on to have in the WWE, but I can't. He had none. Zip, zero, zilch. Husky Harris was quite frankly the Army Tank with a Ferrari engine that just couldn't be a winner if he tried. After failing with the Nexus that was led by CM Punk, Husky Harris would disappear from the WWE, going back down to Florida Championship Wrestling. There was someone who looked awfully familiar though, and they went by the name of Bray Wyatt. The former WWE Champion and Universal Champion Well, wouldn't you know, Husky Harris is Bray Wyatt. The former Army tank went under a character repackage, and it changed his career for the better. Outside of Huskus the Pig, which we see in the Firefly Funhouse, we rarely have never seen or heard of a Husky Harris mentioned in WWE again. It seems that the Nexus rarely gets talked about these days, and less as time goes on. So maybe Husky Harris will be long forgotten, however the Fiend Bray Wyatt's past will always haunt him no matter what. WrestleMania 36. At the time of this recording, WrestleMania 36 is yet to happen. However, I can almost guarantee this will be a WrestleMania that Vince McMahon will want to forget about for as long as the eye can see. Why, you might ask, is WrestleMania 36 not the greatest? Is there a bad main event for the stage? Did the fans not enjoy the plans for the biggest wrestling event of the year? Well, all of those questions would be answered the same. It didn't even matter the answer. Why? Because WrestleMania 36 will be taking place at the WWE Performance Center in front of a grand total of zero live audience members. In the year of 2020, a global crisis began due to a word that I'm not allowed to say on my YouTube channel without being punished for it. It starts with a C and rhymes with Persona Iris. This has left the world in a state of protecting itself by not allowing large gatherings of people. As a result, the professional wrestling business as a whole had to practically stop running in its normal order. Independent professional wrestling has come to a complete halt, with nearly zero promotions running shows. Meanwhile, the WWE and AEW have been running their weekly programming in front of no audience crowds due to the Persona Iris. See what I did there? WrestleMania 36 was forced to be either canceled or rescheduled. However, when there's a way to actually be a decent human being and not a money-hungry person, Vince McMahon seems to do the opposite every single time. Rather than canceling the biggest show of the year, Vince decided to run WrestleMania 36 from the Performance Center over the span of two nights. For the first time in history, WrestleMania will be held on two different nights. And not to mention, WrestleMania 36 is also being taped and will not be live. On top of all of that, for the first time ever, WrestleMania will have a grand total attendance of zero people. This all sums up to Vince McMahon is going to want to forget that this WrestleMania ever happened for a long time to come. The Undertaker's WrestleMania 17 match. This one is honestly a head-scratcher for me, I can't lie. To give a bit of backstory, at WrestleMania 17, The Undertaker faced Triple H in a winning effort, of course. Now on paper, you'd likely think the same thing that I do. How is this a moment that Vince McMahon wants us to forget? Triple H is his daughter's husband, so he's in good standards with the company, and The Undertaker has been one of the most loyal employees to the WWE in history. Why is this a match that Vince McMahon wants us to forget? I don't have an answer to this one, I really don't. All I can tell you is that over a decade later, when The Undertaker faced Triple H at WrestleMania 27, the WWE practically touted it as a first time ever meeting at the big dance for these two. They never mentioned the battle at WrestleMania 17. Oh, but it doesn't stop here though. After The Undertaker defeated Triple H at WrestleMania 27, guess who he faced at WrestleMania 28? If you answered CM Punk, you're off by 1 year. The Undertaker ran it back against Triple H the following year, facing the game at WrestleMania 28 as well. This time, however, the streak and the stakes were raised as Triple H and The Undertaker would do battle inside the Hell in a Cell, a match where both men have competed in more than any other superstar in the company. To make matters more interesting, Shawn Michaels was the special guest referee. You know, Triple H's best friend. Surely The Undertaker was getting screwed, but nope, thankfully The Undertaker's streak was safe for now, and he defeated Triple H. However, that doesn't explain the mystery as to why The Undertaker's WrestleMania 17 match against Triple H never is mentioned. I'm not sure if it's just because they needed to make the WrestleMania 27 match feel more special or what, but you rarely ever hear anyone in the company ever dare make mention towards that WrestleMania 2001 encounter between the game and the dead man. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it, the top five moments that Vince McMahon wants you to completely forget about in the WWE. Now, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. It really helps out the video. Comment down below. Let me know what your favorite moment was of this video. What was your favorite moment that was listed here? I want to know. What do you think the WWE also doesn't want you to remember? Again, I want to know. Comment down below. Let's have a conversation in the comment section. Hopefully you guys can see them trying to do things a little bit differently here on the channel as of late. But nevertheless, guys, as always and forever, take it easy.
My girl, don't lie to me. Tell me, where did you sleep last night?